during one of our live streams, meron tayong viewer na nagtanong. Hello Brian, ask ko lang po if mas okay po ang 5% daily compounding ni CBank than 6% annually compounding ni Maya. Kung napanood nyo yung live stream na yon, then alam nyo na ang sagot ay yung 6% with Maya. Pero bakit? Hindi ba mas maganda na daily compounding? Hindi ba mas mataas ang more earn mo na interest? Well, not necessarily, and I'll show you later. Moreover, what if instead of 2 ay 3 ang choices natin? The first one is yung CBank, which we'll call as Bank A, na may 5% per annum interest but compounding daily. The second choice is yung Maya, which we'll now call as Bank B, na 6% per annum interest na compounding annually. Plus a third option, which we'll call as Bank C, na may 6% per annum interest but compounding monthly. Parang regular savings account. Between Bank A and Bank B, mas mataas ang interest na i-earn ng Bank B, sabi ko dun sa live stream. But with our third choice, yung Bank C, hindi kaya si Bank C na ang better choice? To show you the answer to this question, we have to first learn ano ba yung formula to compute the interest. Ang formula to compute the amount of interest that will be earned can be represented by this equation. A is equal to P times 1 plus R divided by N raised to the nth power. Ang A is the amount of money in the savings account after interest is paid. P is the principal or the original account balance. R is the interest rate, which is written in decimal form. So kung 6% ay 0.06 ang ilalagay natin. And then N is the number of times the bank calculates interest in a year. Let's now try to apply this formula dun sa tatlong choices natin. So with Bank A na may 5% per annum interest na daily compounding, ang equation niya ay magiging ganito. Let's just say na ang principal natin or yung ilalagay natin na pera sa savings account ay 50,000 pesos. So 50,000 times 1 plus 0.05 kasi 5% per annum divided by 365 and all of that raised to the 365 power. Bakit 365? Kasi Bank A is compounding daily. And since N is the number of times the bank calculates interest in a year, so 365 days in a year, kaya yung N natin is 365. So if we put 50,000 pesos in Bank A after a year, meron tayong 52,563.37 pesos. Of course, in reality, mababawasan pa yan kasi meron tayong 20% final withholding tax. But since all banks will apply 20% withholding tax, para mas simple yung computation natin, i-disregard na lang natin siya dun sa mga comparison natin ng numbers. So for Bank A, you'll have 52,500 plus pesos. Paano naman sa Bank B? With Bank B, I will show you na mas mataas ang year-earn na interest ni Bank B na 6% per annum kahit na once a year lang siya or annual lang yung compounding niya. So with the formula, ang equation natin ay magiging ganito. 50,000 times 1 plus 0.06 divided by 1 raised to the 1 power or first power. Kaya siya 1 kasi isang beses lang siya magko-compound or isang beses lang ia-apply yung interest. So if we solve this equation, we will have 53,000 pesos. So as I mentioned during the live stream, if we only have 2 choices, mas mataas ang ibibigay na interest return and a better choice yung Bank B. And I think yung viewer natin, ang tinatanong niya ay yung CBank versus Maya. So Maya would be a better option. It's interesting to note na nakaka-temp ilagay yung pera natin sa isang savings account na nagko-compound daily. Kasi nakaka-excite na makita na araw-araw na dadagdagan yung pera natin. But at the end of it, it seems that mas maganda pa rin yung Bank B na annual nagko-compound kasi mas mataas yung interest rate niya. Pero meron tayong dinagdag na third choice, yung Bank C, which is 6% per annum pero compounding monthly. Kung i-compute natin yung interest na i-earn ng Bank C, magkano kaya yung makukuha natin? So we go back to our equation and apply the formula. So 50,000 times 1 plus 0.06 divided by 12 raised to the 12th power. Kaya siya 12 kasi 12 times magko-compound yung pera natin dahil monthly ina-apply yung interest. And the total will be 53,083.89. Of course, less 20% for the tax, but if we compare the three, Bank C would be the best option. So what have we learned today? When it comes to choosing a bank, kung ang habol natin ay yung pinakamataas na interest return, then the higher interest rate, the better. Yun yung may pinakamataas na returns. And then second is the frequency of interest payments. Mas madalas, mas maganda. Because it allows you to earn interest on top of the interest that you already earned from previous periods. Today, digital banks offer the highest interest rates versus traditional banks. That's why it's good to have some of your money in them. Why only some? Bakit hindi lahat? Well, because the stability of the financial institution is also important. We want to avoid the worst case scenario na mag-close ang bank at maipit ang pera natin. Secondly, most if not all of the high interest rates offered by digital banks are just promotions. They can suddenly end and give you lower interest rates. And also, it's important to consider convenience, accessibility, and quality of customer service of the bank. Because to be honest, mas pipiliin ko ilagay ang pera ko sa isang bank na maayos ang service kesa sa isang banko na mataas nga ang interest rate pero lagi namang offline, pangit ang customer service. Banks are an essential part of our personal finance. And a savings account is where you keep your daily living budget, your emergency fund, and any cash that you might need in the short term or for any upcoming major expense. Beyond this, it's important to put your money in a better earning investment vehicle, such as bonds, mutual funds, stocks, and many others. This way, your money has the potential to grow even faster. That's it, and thank you for watching.